Okay, we're on to the second sequence in the film where the plot begins to get a little momentum going. What does Buster see? The close-up tells us it's the horseshoe. He taps it with his foot. Notice Buster is not really moving, so we can pay attention to the important information. And notice also that the angle of the camera line shooting and the sidewalk is the same in all of these shots. Again, the person with the information is the one who's moving. Quick little look into the camera there. Interesting slide into the shot, the way he runs in. You notice how frantic Buster is, throwing papers around, leaping about, climbing the wall. In a moment, he's going to dive off the wall onto the ground. It seems very frantic. We'll see how he does that in a moment. Very deliberate there. And you notice he leaps in the air and falls on his back. It's a hard fall. Now, notice before everybody takes off running, a lot of standing around, sitting, standing, very slowly, and then he takes off. Forward motion. Okay. Shooting speed. Now, we're cranking at 16 frames per second. I determined this just by looking what's natural, knowing this was transferred at 24. So we're looking at this at 66 2/3% of regular speed, which simulates 16 frames per second. You notice Buster shoved that with his foot so it would become in the way of this gentleman here. Notice all the pauses he's putting in. Stops, looks, pick it up, stop, look. Taking his time. Look at all the pauses that are put in there. Look at this. And notice there's something written on the wall behind Buster. Let's take a good look at that, shall we? Oh, someone's written G.I.P. Funny. And they just left that in. Okay, back to the action. We're cranking now at 14 frames per second. Now, wait a second. Buster's trajectory entering the shot didn't look natural. He seems to be coming from a higher altitude and not running straight in. Let's take a closer look at that. Slow down. He does seem to be entering the shot, perhaps swinging off of a swing or trapeze mounted off a camera range on the left. One of those impossible gags. Now notice that frantic movement that we saw before, but notice it's not doesn't look so frantic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of newspaper. Again, we're cranking at 14, I believe, here. Look at his body weight, especially here. Oof. Did he mean or plan to land off the curb? Not sure. Now, this, being a closer shot, is cranked at 18 frames per second. 1, 2, 3 spits, and then boom. Now, let's take a look at the way, you know, he got hit, and then he jumped in the air and fell. Hit, whoop, and kabam. That's spine on concrete. Now, again, there are a few different cranking speeds here. But we don't notice it because the film is shown at one speed. And that's one of the flexibilities you have in making silent films and using the variable speeds, because it's all shown at one speed. And we're back at 14 here. Usually action is cranked much slower, 12 or 14. Now let's look at that sequence again at projected speed. Okay. He kicks it out. Again, it's so that this guy will see it. Remember all those pauses he put in? They're gone. But they were necessary, like little commas. Otherwise, everybody would look like they were running around like they were on Benny Hill or something. It's done very deliberately so that the information lands and reads. And that strange trajectory he has just adds to the panic that is generated by his rapidly going through those pieces of paper and not putting pauses in. Again, this difference in speeds is completely undetectable here. And the fact that he's leapt in the air and landed on his back after getting hit in the head, we completely buy it. This is something that everybody knew how to do, is to take that leap and do a hard fall on concrete without having to go right to the hospital. Now let's move on to the third sequence in the film. One of the great surreal gags in the film. One of the many surreal gags in the film. As the chase begins with the cigar store Indian or Native American turning on Buster. And again, we'll see in a moment that all these running and chasing scenes are cranked at a much slower speed, 12 or 14. and there's just a quick collision and a quick fall there. This is a great surreal gag. And we don't really see what they're saying. We're not really paying attention to them. We just see them gesture and point with their arms. And that's all we really need to see is we determine what they're saying based on their pointing. And look how deliberate this is. Hey, look at that. Or let's look at that at shooting speed. Now, most of this sequence is shot at 12. I believe it was cranked at around 12. And now notice this. Look at this. He looks and he jumps and pauses before moving again. Buster is taking his time reaching in for a cigarette. And watch the Indian guy. One, two. A full second goes by before he turns. He gets a match struck on him and waits an entire second before reacting. You can see the from the body weight and the movement. This is what made me feel like this was definitely shot at 12, where we're looking at this at 50% speed. You go there and turn that way and make a left and then a right. And watch when the cop jumps in. They both leap into the air just a little bit to soften the blow and then land on the ground. So they're not just banging into each other. Now, I believe we're at 14, and I've enlarged this so we can see just the four guys doing their business and the talking. And take a look. You'll notice the cop on the right is gesturing Buster's hat. You know, a guy with a little hat. I haven't seen him anywhere. Again, he's going to gesture the hat. You know, little hat, flat hat. Hey. Now, watch how much time is taken here. They make the little tableau. Watch how long. One, two, three. Hey, look at that. And they wait, and then they run. Let's take a look at it. At projected speed, 24 frames per second. One, two, three. And you almost don't even notice that hop. Here's a little definition. And again, here, that pause, one, boom. It's perfectly timed. In real life, that 1 second pause seems unnatural. And again, that little leap into the air before they fall is almost erased. It's part of what they needed to do physically to pull off the stunt, and it also gives a little extra punch to the fall. And again, we saw kind of what they were saying, but we're not even aware that he's gesturing the hat. I didn't notice it myself till I slowed this down. We just see them pointing and watch the guy, the main cop, and the amount of time Buster took there pays off because it totally reads. Let's move on.